If you have to store data, it has to be built on a scientific basis. It has to be built on a scientific basis. For example, I told you maps. The maps give us an extension of the knowledge which we have. The maps given extension of the knowledge. From Chennai, we are expanding to the neighboring states. From the neighboring states, I am expanding to the neighboring water body, Arabian Sea, this side Bay of Bengal. From the neighboring water body, I am jumping to the neighboring countries, Middle East. From the Middle East, I am still traveling to the left-hand side or the western side. I go to Africa. From Africa, I travel one country after another country from the east to the west, starting from Egypt, Libya, Algeria. I'm going that way. Then I'm coming across this Atlantic Ocean. I'm traveling to the Atlantic Ocean, crossing the Atlantic Ocean and reaching the coast of east coast of United States of America. Then there is a mountain range, which is an Appalachian mountain range. I'm climbing on top of the Appalachian mountain, getting down, crossing all these rivers which are present there, namely Missouri, Mississippi, Colorado rivers, then crossing the deserts, then going to the Rocky Mountains. Having climbed down the Rocky Mountains, I come to this Pacific Ocean. I travel all the way across the one of the biggest oceans of the world, Pacific Ocean. Then I reach the coast of Hawaii Islands, which are present in the mid of the Pacific Ocean. Then I can imagine seeing the Pearl Harbor, which had been bombed by Japan in the year 1941, 7th December. Then we travel to this Hawaii Islands to the western side furthermore, and we are crossing the international date line, 180 degree east, 180 degree west. Then I am finally reaching the east coast of Japan. I traveled from the west coast of India, reached in the east coast of Japan. Then from then on, I am traveling to China. Of course, crossing this Korea, traveling to China. Then from China, I gradually, if I have to come down, I travel across all the countries which I call it is Indochina, which is namely Vietnam, which is namely Cambodia, which is Laos. Then I come to Thailand. Then I come to Myanmar. From Myanmar, I jump into Bangladesh. From Bangladesh, again, I take West Bengal coast. Then I come to Odisha. Then I come to Andhra. Then finally come to Tamil Nadu and settle in Chennai. One small trip. But the point is to perceive things in the mind, you have to have a clear understanding of the map. Map is a two-dimensional world. Every day you can see map, two-dimensional world. And gradually from then on, you can build this map. I have gone from Chennai in the western side. I have reached Chennai in the eastern side, circumnavigating the world. If you know the map, you can go in any way. You can go to the north, come around the South Pole and again reach Chennai. And if you know the map well, you can do anything. On these routes which I have gone, I can build data. On the routes I have gone, I can build political data, social data, economic data. All data could be built on the route which I have taken. So only you have to be familiar with certain locations, some rivers, some mountains, then cities would come. First, to study the map, geography has to be geographical map, that is a physical map has to be studied. People do the vice versa. First, they do the political map, then they study the physical map. That is a wrong approach. Somebody had misguided them actually. Some competitor might be thinking that if one competition is reduced, maybe it is good for them. First, you have to build a physical map because it is the geographical physical features which decide the human features, the human geography. It is not without coincidence that when you study geography, the first topic of any geography book is physical geography. First chapter, why not they give human geography? Why not they give economic geography? Why not they give regional geography? Why not they straight away take up climates? No. First physical, then climate, then of course ocean they go. Then after completing these three, they speak about population and settlement. Then they speak about environment. Then they speak about economy. Then they speak about agriculture. Then they speak about all other drainage patterns. Everything they speak one by one afterwards. So I am essentially telling that geography could be studied. The whole UPSC syllabus could be studied in a very scientific, in a very simple manner. And you should have that guidance to do that. So that is what actually we are doing in this all these sessions. That's what we are doing in all these sessions. So study geography in the scientific manner so that your knowledge expands. And using this map, you could learn so much and you can learn variety of the subjects in a very organized manner.